Welcome to Exports and Import Procedure video. After going through this video, you must be able to enumerate the export and import procedure. India ranks 19th in the list of top 30 merchandise exporters globally and 13th amongst importers. According to the WTO report published by the Press Trust of India, PTI, in the year 2016, with increasing trade liberalization, new business ventures are on the rise in India with the objective of global trade. However, this requires the entrepreneurs to have extensive awareness of the export and import procedures in India. With both domestic and international trade, businesses are prone to various risks with high degree due to global trade. Nevertheless, the risk can be minimized following appropriate procedures and documentation in the international trade arena. Export documentation and procedures are necessary to help prevent the goods from being rejected, discarded, or wasted due to failure in obtaining clearance certificate from the concerned port. To export or import goods from or to India, individuals or businesses must acquire an Import-Export Code or IEC code from the Directorate General of Foreign Trade. An export order is a written document in which the terms and conditions of trade are mutually decided by the importer and the exporter. Once the exporter receives the final export order, the export process is commenced. Now the exporter analyzes the order with regard to the terms and conditions. The exporter validates on the complete name and address of the buyer, description of the products, terms and modes of payment, need of inspection and insurance, and time delivery. Then he, the exporter, confirms the order. Exporters can acquire finance from the Reserve Bank of India, also known as the RBI, under the Export Credit Interest Subsidy Scheme to meet their working capital requirements, namely purchase of raw materials, production of final goods, and so on. The kind of financing is termed as pre-shipment credit. Once the credit is received, the exporter commences the production of goods or services. Once the goods are manufactured, exporter applies for clearance form, the Central Excise Duty. According to the Central Excise and Sales Act of India, there are two schemes that enables exporter with 100% rebate on duty on submitting the proof of shipment. According to the first scheme, the excise duty is paid when the export consignment is dispatched from the factory and the claim for rebate is filed after exporting the goods. Now, to claim the rebate after paying the excise duty, an exporter should submit Gate Pass GP1 and the AR4 form to the Superintendent of Central Excise Department in concern the locality. According to the second scheme, no payment is made when goods are dispatched from the factory, but a bond is signed with the excise authorities. The bond is usually backed by a bank guarantee or surety to an amount equivalent to the excise duty. In this case, to get a clearance from the excise authority, the exporter must fill form AR4 or AR4A and submit to the Central Excise Range Superintendent. As per the government norms, some of the goods require quality certification before their shipment. Thus, inspection of such goods is termed as pre-shipment inspection. It can be conducted for the following items: consignment-wise inspection, in-process quality control, and self-certification. Exporters get three copies of inspection certificate. One copy is for customer verification, second is sent to the importer, and the third copy remains with the exporter for the future reference. Only after receiving the inspection certification copy, the custom authorities allow the shipment to process further. On receipt of the inspection certificate, the exporter appoints clearing and forwarding agents. These agents are involved in packing, marking, and labeling of consignment, arranging transportation from warehouse to port, from port to overseas shipment, clearance of cargo from customs, procuring transport, and other documents. The exporter must produce certain documents to such agents, including commercial invoice, 8 to 10 copies, customer declaration form, triplet copy, packaging list, original copy of letter of certificate, original and duplicate copy of GR form, original and duplicate copy of AR4 or AR4A form, original copy of GP1, GP2, and railway receipt lorry way bill, whichever applies. Once the clearing and forwarding agents are appointed by the exporters, these agents pack, mark, and label goods for export. Proper packing, marking, and labeling of goods help in their quick and safe transportation. The clearing and forwarding agents ensure that ship has enough space to transport the goods safely to the importer. These agents or freight brokers who work either on behalf of ship company or as an employee of the shipping company reserve space for goods on the ship. Then the shipping company produces a document to the exporter called as a shipping order. For transporting goods to the port, The clearing and the forwarding agents can use road. If goods are to be sent by road to the port, there's no specific formality involved. Rail. If goods are sent by rail, the clearing and forwarding agent must reserve a wagon and obtain the necessary documents from the railway board as an evidence to the wagon reservation. Hence, the agents provide a forwarding note, a railway document, shipping order, and a wagon registration fee receipt to the railway yard station. On wagon allocation, the goods are loaded and the railway issue a railway receipt, RR, to the clearing and forwarding agents present at the port town along with the other required documents. Simultaneously, the export department ensures the goods internally as well as overseas to address their risk covers. After receiving necessary documents, the clearing and the forwarding agents receive the goods from the railway station or the road transport and transfer them to the warehouse. They also get clearance from port authorities to receive the cargo in the shipment shed. To get custom clearance, the clearing and forwarding agents must submit the shipping bill, contract form, letter of credit, commercial invoice, GR form, inspection certificate, AR4, AR4A form, and the packaging list. Next, the clearing and forwarding agents must get clearance and permission from the shed superintendent of the port, dock appraiser, and the preventive officer to transfer the goods to the ship. When the goods are boarded onto the vessel, the ship captain provides a receipt to the shed superintendent of the port called as mate's receipt. After paying port charges, the clearing and forwarding agents get the mate receipt. This receipt is submitted to the shipping company and then they issue the bill of landing. The bill of landing along with all other necessary documents are dispatched to the exporter by clearing and forwarding agents. On receipt of these documents, the exporter applies to the Chamber of Commerce for obtaining certificate of origin. Generalized Scheme of Preferences, also known as GSP concession, allows developing countries to pay less or no duties on their exports to the European Union. In case the exports are made to the countries providing GSP concession, the exporters needs to obtain GSP certificate of origin from the concerned authority. Finally, the exporter sends a document to the importer that includes date of shipment of the consignment, destination of the consignment, and the expected arrival time to the importer called the shipment advice. Along with this, bill of lading, commercial invoice, packaging list, and customs invoice are also sent to the importer. Exporter provides certain documents to the bank, namely commercial invoice, certificate of origin, packaging list, letter of credit, marginal insurance policy, GR form, bill of lading, bill of exchange, bank certification, and commercial invoice to release the money due with the importer. Once the processing of export order is completed, the exporter can claim his or her admissible incentives. The summary of the tutorial on exports and import procedure has been put on the screen. I'll pause for a few seconds to allow you to go through it. Follow the export procedure to export our goods.